This evening, we are learning more about a teenager shot and killed by officers in Edmond.
Isaiah Lewis was a senior in high school, and police say in the past couple of hours, he was shot during a struggle with an officer. We just got the 911 calls made before that shooting. Take a listen.
Yes, I'm at 1901 Lariat Circle, and it's a woman. Back up. I don't know you, so I need you to back up.
Okay, and what is going on there?
And what is going on, ma'am?
Is this 911?
Yes, this is 911.
Listen to me. It's my house. I'm with the postman. I'm sorry. You can come to my house and check everything out, but my boyfriend just flipped out. I have no idea what's going on. He's 17 years old.
Those were the moments before the shooting. Edmond police giving more details about the decision to shoot Lewis.
Our use of force training initially would be hands-on and then deploy the taser, and we know that both of those happened, and then obviously firing a handgun if the other two tactics aren't successful.
But tonight, there are conflicting stories and questions from Isaiah Lewis's family and friends.
Specifically, Lewis's girlfriend, who neighbors say he was fighting with before the shooting. News 4's Lele Zhang talked to her.
I didn't want to believe that it was true, and I still, am in denial.
Camry Pollock says it was her boyfriend fatally shot by police in an Edmond neighborhood on Monday. People close to the 17-year-old identifying him as Isaiah Lewis. As friends learn to live with a new reality, police continue to investigate.
Where we are in the investigation right now is figuring out what happened inside the house. The facts that we know right now are that both officers were violently assaulted in this confrontation inside the house.
Jenny Wagner with the Edmond Police Department says it started as a domestic call at a neighborhood near West Edmond and Santa Fe. She said the teenager reportedly stripped his clothing and broke into a house. Pollock says they were arguing.
He was acting like himself, but at the same time, something was, wrong.
And things spiraled out of control as police were being called.
I don't think they needed to get involved at all. When the neighbor was on the phone with them, I was just trying to stay calm. I started to take your phone from her, and she's like, no, don't take my phone from me.
She ran across the street, as you heard in the 911 call, wanting police help because her boyfriend was flipping out.
What also remains unclear, how many shots were fired. Police say they first deployed a taser after an apparent scuffle.
I just miss him. This isn't the first time that I've had someone taken away from me so unexpectedly.
In Edmond, Lele Zhang, Oklahoma's News 4.
All right, Lele, thank you. Police say the officers involved have not been interviewed yet. Their names have not been released to the public.